Hi there and welcome to another session of Accountancy for the 12th Standard with me, Vishwanath Sir. We last wound up the chapter Accounting Ratios in the part B of your analysis of financial statements and tools for statement. We did Accounting Ratios where we did the different types of ratios. Now we come to a completely new chapter in Partnership Accounts. And we are ready to take off from where we last left, that was admission of a partner. Okay, from admission of a partner, now we'll be moving to another chapter which is known as retirement of a partner. Now, firstly and most important, before we go any further, it's important for us to know what is the difference between admission and retirement of a partner. Okay, in generally in layman terms, it is a very easy thing to explain. That in admission a partner comes in and in a retirement the partner goes out. But accounting wise it is not the same. There are minor adjustments. Like for example, let's take the revaluation account which we did in admission. In admission, in revaluation account, if you remember, the profit or loss of revaluation only went to the old partners. Okay, the new partner didn't have any share. But in case of revaluation account in, remember, revaluation account in retirement, the revaluation profit or loss will be shared by all the three partners, the existing partners and the retiring partners, all three. So the old ratio again will come into the picture. So we take this into account. Now, let's see what is the difference between the partner's capital account. As you know, partner's capital account, assume there are three partners, A, B and C, and C is retiring. So, at the end of it, we write two balance carried down. Okay, now this two balance carried down will only be for the existing partners A and B. For C, it will be two C's loan account. Okay, and this will also be transferred to the liability. Okay, another thing in partner's capital account, if there's any general reserve, if there's any workman's compensation reserve, if there's any investment fluctuation reserve or P&L on either side, that is your liability or your assets, this all will be distributed to all the partners. This all will be distributed to all the partners, not just the two partners which used to get in case of admission. In case of retirement, all the three partners will be getting a share of it. Okay, so that was as far as revaluation account is concerned. Cash is not a problem. In your retirement of a partner, you do not need to open a goodwill account. You do not need to open a goodwill account. Okay, and as far as we are concerned, the balance sheet is now deleted from the portion from admission of a partner. Remember, we have done this, but it's fine. Okay, but we, in case of retirement, balance sheet is there, so it becomes quite an important question now in retirement that you do the questions properly. Okay. So, in case of retirement, the balance sheet will be there. In case of admission, you have to only do up till your four accounts, that is your revaluation account, partner's capital account, cash bank account and goodwill account. Also, goodwill account is an option, but in case of retirement, there is no goodwill account, we go directly to the revised balance sheet. Now, what do we do in case of goodwill? Now, in case of goodwill, the journal entry past will be existing partner's capital account debit. We took ABC and we told C retire. So it will be A's capital account debit, B's capital account debit to the retiring partner. Who's the retiring partner? C is the retiring partner. So the journal entry for goodwill in case of retirement of a partner will be A's capital account debit, B's capital account debit to C's capital account. Okay, and it will be something like a contra entry which will come on both the sides of your partner's capital account. On the credit side, you will write by A's capital and by B's capital, and you will put the amounts in the C's capital column. While as on the debit side, you write to C's capital and you'll put the amount in A and B's column. Now remember one thing more. This goodwill will be distributed in the gaining ratio or the gain ratio. Okay, gain ratio or gaining ratio is new ratio minus the old ratio. Okay, and again the gaining ratio will be only for the existing partners. It will not be for the partner who has left the firm. Okay, these are certain changes which is there, the difference is there in retirement and death. Let's go directly to a problem so it becomes easier for us to understand how to go about and do a particular sum. Okay, now in this particular sum, you have got three partners, that is A, B and C, and they are sharing the profits and losses in the ratio 3:2:1. Also, if you see the last adjustment, A and B continue to carry on the business and share the profits and losses equally. So the new ratio is given as 1:1. So it becomes compulsory for us to calculate the gaining ratio. Okay, it becomes compulsory for us to calculate the gaining ratio. Now, as I told you, the accounts which need to be opened will be very simple. It will be revaluation account, partner's capital account, and we are going to open a revised balance sheet. There, we are not going to open goodwill account, we are not going to open cash account. Okay, so have a look at the sum. First and foremost, you have got ABC. You will put the balance of ABC in the partner's capital account as by balance brought down 1 lakh, 1 lakh and 1 lakh, whatever is given in the sum. In this sum, it's given as 1 lakh, 1 lakh and 1 lakh. Okay, then there is general reserve. Kindly distribute the general reserve amongst all the three partners by general reserve in the old ratio 3:2:1. Okay, 3:2:1, which means 60,000 will be divided in the ratio 3:2:1. That is 3/6 of 60,000, 2/6 of 60,000 and 1/6 of 60,000, which is 30,000, 20,000 and 10,000. Okay, so it will be distributed like that. The first adjustment which comes here is that we have to provide doubtful debts 5% on debtors. Now, what is the meaning of provision for doubtful debts? It means that this much amount we might not get from the debtors. We might not get from the debtors. So what do we do? Go to the sundry debtors and minus 5%. The sundry debtors amount is 90,000 minus 5% will be 4,500. This will go on the debit side of your revaluation account. Why debit side of revaluation account? Because the value of the asset has fallen down. The value of the asset has fallen down. So it will go on the debit side of revaluation account and your sundry debtors will be 90,000 minus 4,500, that is 85,500. They have also told reduce stock by 5% and machinery by 10%. So stock is 70,000, you reduce it by 5%, you minus it 3,500. If the value of the asset goes down, we put it on the debit side of revaluation account to stock 3,500, and minus 3,500 from stock, which will give you 66,500. Also, your machinery has to be minus by 10%. The value of machinery is 60,000. You have to depreciate. Depreciate means there is a fall in the value. If there is a fall in the value of the asset, it comes on the debit side because it is a loss for us. So it will come as two machinery 6,000. Your building is revalued at 151. Your actual value of building is 1,40,000. So it has gone up by 11,000. So this you put it on the credit side of your revaluation account. That is by building 11,000. Goodwill of the firm is valued at 1,50,000. Okay, this is the goodwill of the firm. Now who is retiring? C is retiring. Take 1/6 of that amount. Okay, take 1/6 of that amount. That will give you round about 25,000. 25,000 is the amount which C has to get. Okay, now the journal entry for this will be it will be the existing partners to the retiring partners. But when we calculate the gaining ratio, A becomes 0 and B gets 1. So the journal entry will be B to C. Okay, so you write by B's capital and put it in C's column, and you put the other one as 2C's capital on the debit side and put it in B's column. Okay, that's all for the adjustment. Close the revaluation account, transfer the profits of the revaluation account to the profit or loss. I think in this case it is a loss of 3,000. That is 1,500. Okay, and your partner's capital account, you will transfer this on the debit side because it's a loss. Close your partner's capital account. C will go to C's loan account and A will be to balance carried down. Okay, and whichever entries which you have not made, write it down as it is and the balance sheet will tally. Thank you so much. This is Vishwanath sir signing off.